Hey, what's up guys? Matt Laidlaw here, coming to you from Laidlaw's Harley-Davidson, Los Angeles area's oldest, largest, and finest dealership. So today, guys, I am gonna be doing a test ride and a review and kind of giving you some general information about the new 2017 Harley-Davidson Tri-Glide, the trike they make, one of two trikes they make, the other one being the freewheeler. Alright guys, so I'm going to start with a walk around of the bike. This is the brand new 2017 Harley-Davidson Tri-Glide. So like I said earlier, this is one of two different trikes Harley-Davidson makes right now. So this is considered their full dresser, all the bells and whistles, best of the best trike that they have. So this bike first was released by the Harley-Davidson Motor Company in 2009. And this comes to you as a full factory trike. In years prior to 2009, there were a lot of kits out there that you could bolt on to, like Electroglides and whatnot, to make them trikes, but this is a full factory trike. So first of all, you have a lot of the bells and whistles that come on like an ultra limited. For example, you have the full LED lighting up front. The front end of the trike is raked out a little bit more than your standard two-wheeler ultra limited. So you've got in this model year the brand new Milwaukee 8 107 cubic inch engine in there. This is the twin cooled engine, so in the lower leg fairings there you've got the coolant reserves and the radiators, and you know, it pumps. There's a pump that pumps and circulates water up through the heads. The design and the way it operates is similar to in 2014 when they came out with the Project Rushmore and came out with the twin cooled engine. Of course, you know, the design is different now that it's a completely different engine. It's the Milwaukee 8 now as opposed to the 103 high output twin cam. So as far as true trikes go, and there's really not a whole lot of options out there as far as competitors in the market. The only other one I can really think of off the top of my head that's a true trike would be like Honda's trike. I've never ridden those before. So in these trikes you have plenty of space. This back trunk area is really, really big. I mean, you have enough space back there, enough room for like a standard cooler size. It's about 1.5 times what you get in like the tour pack area. And yeah, the fit and finish on this is really, really nice too. Just the doors and the latches are real solid, really high quality, as you'd expect from Harley-Davidson. The latch on the saddlebag, they redesigned that in 2014 with the Project Rushmore, but it's really high quality. You've got bag liners, you got a leather pouch back here. Here's a shot of, you know, pricing on these bikes. So the pricing is kind of dictated by the color you get, vivid black being the least expensive. But you're between about $34,000 and $36,000, depending on what color you choose, you know, whether it be a solid pearl color or two-tone. The bike also comes with one of the premium stereo headsets. So these are the headsets that attach to a helmet that you can plug in and communicate. So here's your trike model's owner's manual. And then there's a separate owner's manual that comes with everything equipped with the boom audio infotainment system. So there's that. And there's a unique trike orientation DVD that comes with these bikes as well to help you kind of get the general idea of the operation of the bike. So this motorcycle has four speakers on it. You've got the two back by the passenger seat, and you have the two front speakers in the fairing. You only have one antenna. That's because this bike is not equipped with the CB radio, so you just got the AM FM stereo on here. You can always add the CB radio to this. That's an add-on. So here's a shot of the new Milwaukee 8 engine. Again, it's 107 cubic inch, 4 valves per cylinder, 2 plugs per cylinder as well. Something that's unique to the trikes is you've got this steering dampener up front. That's actually a key component to these things, to keeping the front wheel from, you know, rattling and jiggling back and forth when you're riding, especially at high speeds on the freeway. You're definitely going to need that. button I just pressed is for the two auxiliary headlamps, the LED headlamps up front. Here's a shot of those. Extremely good lighting on this bike, guys. This is LED stuff. If you were to buy this stuff separately, you'd pay about $1,000 to upgrade a halogen lamp bike to a LED system. Turn signals are integrated into the taillights on the fenders and in the tour pack as well. The tour pack light bar is all LED as well. The bulbs in the fenders are halogen bulbs. Alright, so we're going to start this thing up now so you guys can hear the engine. So I'm real happy with the new Milwaukee 8. You know, I've said it in several of my videos now, but the new engine really works well in this new trike as well. One of the things that I noticed is the new torque, or the added torque benefit of the Milwaukee 8 really helps out on this trike. This trike weighs a little over 1,200 pounds. That extra 10% in the torque really help get this bike off the line really well. Here's another shot kind of the lines, the coolant lines that feed into the heads to really keep the engine cool. The new Milwaukee 8 engine also has a counterbalancer on there and a lower idle speed, so less vibration that I'm sure you guys noticed at a standstill on these bikes. So overall, the Harley-Davidson Tri-Glide is a really fun bike to ride. There's always a lot of skepticism when someone maybe reaches an age where they no longer feel comfortable about a two-wheeler, or whatever your reason might be for riding on a three-wheeler. The skepticism is usually, you know, that they're not going to have as much fun as they did on a two-wheeler, and you know, I definitely would disagree with that. I think these bikes are a lot of fun to ride. You know, even, you know, someone at my age who is fully capable of riding a two-wheel vehicle, I have a lot of fun on these bikes. So a couple things that you should know right out of the gate, though, that is significantly different on a three-wheel Harley-Davidson as opposed to a two-wheeler is the handling is significantly different. So the turning is all in the handlebars. You know, you're pretty much just twisting the handlebars and the steering head to make your turns as opposed to leaning on a two-wheel bike. So you know, these bikes have what can be described as go-kart type handling, where, you know, it's very much, you know, on a rail, quick turning. I will say that initially, if you turn too hard or get too aggressive with these bikes, you may feel like your butt's sliding off the seat. You know, you get over that pretty quickly, and you kind of predict that coming, and so you get used to it. But the first time you get on one of these bikes and you do a quick sharp turn, you know, you may feel like the centrifugal force is going to pull you off the bike, but you quickly get over that. One of the things I will say is you know, if you take one of these motorcycles up on like a real twisty canyon road, I've had some of my customers that I've sold these motorcycles to say that their upper body can get fatigued because, again, the turning is all in the upper body, and you know, so you're not using your body weight and just leaning to go through the turns. You know, I haven't ever experienced that, you know, getting fatigued. You know, I find these bikes pretty easy to ride, but I can see why that might be the case, you know, on really twisty, windy roads. The other thing I will say that is maybe kind of a con that I found about these trikes is the suspension in the rear end, when you hit large bumps, isn't that great. So when you go up a curb, like this situation right here that I'm going up, you really feel it. And you know, these bikes have a straight axle, and so, you know, one of the things really from when they were first built in 2009 that hasn't really changed is, you know, any shock you feel, and you can see kind of in this shot here, the front end really, you know, wobbles too when you're going up a curb. So, and that's really the nature of a trike as well. You know, there's not a whole lot you can do about that, but, you know, in any shock you feel on the right wheel, you know, it transfers it to, you know, the left side and the front end as well pretty easily. So, but, you know, if you're going down on a flat surface, a flat road, and, you know, you're just hitting your normal everyday, you know, small imperfections on the road, you know, this bike is actually a really very comfortable overall feel to it. The seat is Harley-Davidson's, you know, really plush two-up seat that you're going to find on an Ultra Limited. So the seat's really comfortable, and the suspension does a pretty dang good job. You got the bigger 49mm front forks on this bike that came out in the 2014 Project Rushmore. So it does really good at absorbing the shock for the most part. The clutch is real easy to manage on this bike. You've got a hydraulic clutch on this motorcycle, so real easy actuation and real predictable actuation and lower maintenance as well, as opposed to a cable clutch. The system of the audio and the infotainment system, as it's referred to, is top notch on this motorcycle. It was brand new in the 2014 model year when these new Batwing fairings came out with the vented system. But yeah, the radio's here. This is a 6.5 GT infotainment system. It comes standard with navigation. You've got a USB port in the right side of the radio there in that trap door, so you can plug in your iPhone, iPod. A lot of times I just put a flash drive in there and play my music off of it. If you hook up the headset that I showed you, that box at the beginning of the video, you can voice command your system here. You can also take phone calls on it. And when I say voice command, what I'm referring to is you can voice command your GPS, your music, and your phone. So I could say, like, call John Smith, and it would call him up, and I would never have to leave my handlebars with my hands. So all hands-free dialing and stuff. So yeah, pretty dang useful. The trike, it's got really good storage space. The power is really nice. I think I mentioned earlier already the new Milwaukee 8 with the 107 cubic inch engine powers this thing really nicely down the road. One of the things I noticed with the old trikes from 2009 to 2016 is it took a little bit of a higher RPM off the line to get these things moving. And with the new 10% torque that the Milwaukee 8 gives you, I feel like the power is a lot better proportionately for the weight of this motorcycle. This motorcycle is about 1,200 pounds. So the Milwaukee 8 powertrain is pretty dang nice on this motorcycle. You've also got a reverse gear on this thing, and it's a separate electric motor that powers a separate gear that gives you the reverse capabilities on here, and I'll demonstrate that. So there's a button on your left thumb there above the horn. It says R. You hold that down, and then the green neutral indicator turns into a yellow light, as you just saw there. And you hold down that R, and then you will start to go into reverse. And you do this when you're in neutral. When you're done, you just pull in the clutch, drop it back into first gear, and then that yellow R will deilluminate, and then you just take off again. It's very simple, very integrated system that's very fluid, easy to use. So as I mentioned before, the Milwaukee 8 has plenty of power to power this thing and get it down the road. It does a lot better job than its predecessor, the Twin Cam 103. But this engine puts out about 103 foot-pounds of torque at the rear wheel and about 80 horsepower at the rear wheel. So yeah, it's got plenty of torque and power to move this real big heavy piece of machinery down the road. And you know, just wrapping through the gears, you know, it feels very comparable to, you know, what a Harley-Davidson typically feels like. Obviously it's a heavier bike, and so it's not going to be, you know, as fast as, you know, your counterpart, a two-wheeler like Ultra Limited. But it does pretty well. You have no problem keeping up with your two-wheel buddies on the freeways and things like that on this motorcycle, and it's really comfortable. The Tri-Glide is excellent for two-up riding. You've got the wraparound backrest that attaches to the King Tour Pack back there, and this Tour Pack is the same that you're going to find on, you know, any of the other Electric Glide two-wheel bikes. So a lot of comfort in this motorcycle. You can ride it for a really long time. Not today, but in years past, I've ridden these for, you know, several hundred miles, and they're really comfortable. You get off and, you know, it's no problem. You're not fatigued at all on these things. You got a little bit taller windshield than, say, like a Street Glide. So, you know, the wind deflection is really good. You can see right there, I went through some potholes and it kind of jars the bike. So again, that's really the only drawback or con that I would find with these trikes, is the ride when going through like major bumps. It's not as good as like your two-wheeler. It's kind of like if you've ever ridden like an ATV, like a four-wheeler off-road or something like that, and then jumped on a two-wheeler dirt bike. It's about the same. You know, on a four-wheeler, you got four wheels. You're just going to feel more of, you know, the bumps and things than you would on like a two-wheeler. So that's actually probably the best comparison I can draw, is if you've ever ridden like an ATV, a four-wheeler ATV, you know, this kind of has that same rear end feel to it. But yeah, it does really great up on the highway. You should have no problem keeping up with your two-wheel buddies on it. Stereo system's nice. You got 25 watts per channel, four speakers. You know, they definitely improved this in 2014, so nothing's changed there since 2014. The engine runs really cool. These water-cooled heads and system does a real good job. Today that when I'm riding the bike, it wasn't a very hot day. It was like in the 60s, what I consider to be perfect motorcycle riding weather. But you know, on the real hot days, you know, this engine's real efficient at keeping the heat radiating up onto you at a minimum. So it does that real well. Rear visibility is decent with the mirrors. You can always buy the extensions. If you want to get Sirius XM satellite radio on this, you can do that. You have to buy an additional attachment. It costs about $400, but you can get that on here, and it doesn't come stock though. So guys, real short in conclusion, really the Tri-Glide is good for anybody. I wouldn't pigeonhole it to just people that maybe have some type of physical ailment where they can no longer ride a two-wheel bike. I have a lot of people buying these that just feel more comfortable with three wheels. Maybe they've ridden two-wheelers for a long time and they just want a more relaxed, easygoing ride, and that's usually, you know, why people buy this. Of course, I do get a lot of people that are no longer able to ride on two wheels for whatever physical handicap or whatever it may be, and they love it. I've sold a lot of these bikes over the years, and people absolutely love them. I've never had someone buy one and bring it back and say, yeah, I just don't like it. I've probably only had two in 7 years traded in, and that was because people bought them for the purposes of riding with a spouse, and the spouse ended up not riding with them, and so they traded it in and got a two-wheel bike. But anyways, I absolutely love the bike. If you live in Southern California and you're interested in purchasing one, please hit me up. You know where to find me. If you liked the video, give me a thumbs up and like the YouTube video here. And yeah, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments section below. I'm pretty good about getting back to people and answering any questions you may have. Here are some stat sheets on the Tri-Glide Ultra. kind of gives you the length, the width, the height of the motorcycle, your pricing options. Again, this comes with the twin cooled Milwaukee 8107. This one is the freewheeler. It's the chopped down version. You basically, you lose the tour pack, the fairing and the radio and everything. So hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Ride safe. Thank you very much.